Welcome, geometry scholars, to another example of the Pythagorean theorem, our famous theorem of a squared plus b squared equals c squared. Again, c is the hypotenuse. So if I look at my picture here, 4 root 3 and 4 root 3 are the two legs. X is my hypotenuse. So I'm going to substitute x in for c. And that's one of the most important values to find. So x goes in for c. And in for a and b, I'm going to do 4 root 3 squared plus 4 root 3 squared. Now, off to the side over here in red, I'm going to calculate 4 root 3 squared. 4 root 3 squared means 4 root 3 times 4 root 3. That's the same as 16 times the square root of 9. The square root of 9 is 3, and 16 times 3 is 48. So now, I can take this 48 and plug it in back up here for 4 root 3 squared, and I really have 48 plus 48 equals x squared. So 96 equals x squared, and x is the square root of 96. And now I need to do some simplifying again and put this in a simpler form. For 96, I could do 16 times 6. And I could simplify the square root of 16 to 4. So my answer for x is going to be 4 times the square root of 6. Remember those square numbers you want to choose for 96? I'm going to put them over here to the side. So when I was looking for numbers to simplify 96, I've got 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, 36, 49. Those are all the numbers that I know the square roots. Square root of 16 is 4. So I chose 16 over here, and I'm going to highlight it with this laser pointer so you can see it. That 16 was my best choice for going into 96, 16 times 6. And my answer was 4 times the square root of 6.